My name is Stephanie Mueller, and I'm an associate professor here at MIT CSE, and I head the HCI engineering group. Human-computer interaction is a really exciting and unique research area where we study the intersection between people and technology. And in particular, my research lab looks at how do people actually interact with physical objects, and are there some unique opportunities that we haven't explored yet in, you know, giving physical objects some digital capabilities to make the interaction more interesting. So one example is, for instance, that we have reprogrammable appearances for objects. So that, for instance, let's say a shoe can actually change its outside appearance and color pattern as many times as you want. And that really transforms entire industries. So previously, analog industries that would just manufacture a physical product now actually become digital industries.
One of the projects that we work on is Photochromelion. This is a smart material that can reprogram the appearance of objects using photochromic dyes. So what the fundamental principle is of these photochromic materials is that they are bistable. So there's like one state where this material is transparent. There's a second state where this material is saturated or colorful pretty much. So in our basic idea behind this was that we utilize like a color model, this cyan, magenta and yellow color model that is also used in inkjet printing, for example, to create a larger color space, like a larger color spectrum. And then when you are able to control each one of these photochromic particles individually, and you can like set the saturation to, for example, 50% yellow, 80% magenta and 10% cyan, you can achieve pretty much any kind of color in the full color spectrum. And then the second technical contribution that we had to achieve was to develop a projection system and a computational model to control the saturation of these photochromic dyes.
For the automotive industry, our reprogrammable color-changing coding has a lot of applications. So one big limitation of car sharing at the moment is that, you know, customers have to take the car as it is, but people love to customize it, and that could actually raise how much customers would like to use the car sharing, which obviously has benefits for sustainability as well.
Primarily, my research is about creating technologies that are for and inspired by creative practices. So prior to MIT, I was actually an art major, double majoring in computer science. For quite a long time, I was really interested in just trying to combine those two interests in a meaningful way. And I felt like HCI is just a really interesting sort of interdisciplinary area in CS that would allow me to also explore sort of creative or artistic interests.
I think Stephanie has done a really good job in terms of, you know, the students within this group. I think everyone comes in with something different. A fun fact, everyone is also from, you know, a different part of the world, which even makes this group more diverse in more ways compared to just their discipline and their experiences.
We have like students that come from electronics engineering, mechanical engineering, art and design. And by having all of these people in the lab, we can create all of these really interdisciplinary projects. The projects we lead are a combination of what the student is interested in and what I'm interested in. So for instance, I have one student who is very interested in robotics and space. And we are actually now working on a project related to space robotics, where he's creating self-assembling modules that he can actually deploy in space and that create like structures. Something that's super important for us is that the research we do is mind-blowing and has this kind of wow effect when you look at it. And the reason why this is so important is because I believe that research is also there to actually make people think and think about the future. And I think if the research is not exciting enough or provoking enough that you're really reflecting on, wow, you know, could this change my future? What effect could this have on my life and, you know, how I go about my day? I think the research is kind of missing out on one important point there.